From Star Trek to Marvel and everywhere in between, science fiction loves itself a good old-fashioned interweaving tale of parallel universes. But for some, for increasing numbers in fact, the idea that this reality isn't all there is really starting to catch on. Other dimensions and apparent glitches between here and there continually crop up in actual, real life. So, here are some of the most compelling examples of all. This is Unveiled, and today we're taking a closer look at two more parallel universe stories that will make you question reality. Do you need the big questions answered? Are you constantly curious? Then why not subscribe to Unveiled for more clips like this one, and ring the bell for more thought-provoking content. Today's episode is also a follow-up to a past video, in which we focused on bizarre instances like the story of the man from Torrid, the mystery of the Marcahuasi Stone Forest in Peru, and an apparently six-lane highway to nowhere in Spain. It's not as though these cases stand alone, however, and there are in fact plenty more claims of proof of parallel worlds out there. Some are recollections of blink-and-you'll-miss-them type visions, and there are some others that stay with their claimants for an entire lifetime. First today, the incredible story of Lerina Garcia from Spain. In 2008, when Garcia was 41 years old, she posted onto a Spanish online forum asking for help, as she'd come to believe that she may have jumped into a parallel universe. According to Garcia, the world around her had changed in subtle but definite ways, leading her to think that one morning she had simply woken up in a different version of the reality she had lived in up until the night before. The first change was her bedsheets, which she literally didn't recognize as belonging to her. At this point, confused but still not suspecting what was to come, she got up, went through her usual daily routine, and went to work. But when she got there, she found unknown people in her building, and then that her name had been replaced on her office door. After a little searching, she found that while she did still work for the same company, she was apparently employed in a totally different position. The day before, everything had been as it normally was. But today, everything was different. By now, Lerina was beginning to get seriously worried, and so she visited her doctor to check for any physical abnormalities, including the possible presence of drugs or alcohol in her system, but she was given a clean bill of health, no substances were present, and was sent on her way. Things quickly got even stranger, however, when her own boyfriend was nowhere to be found. But when she then came to learn that she was, in fact, still with her ex-boyfriend, who she'd broken up with a few months beforehand, her entire life had seemingly rewritten itself. Other members of Garcia's family were at least the same people, but more inconsistencies kept coming up, including that her sister had apparently no longer had shoulder surgery, despite Garcia distinctly remembering that she just recently had been to the hospital for the procedure, and also that many of Garcia's messages and emails had apparently disappeared too. For the most part, the rest of the world hadn't drastically changed, but this one person's personal life had dramatically altered. And while it's difficult to verify the story, some believe that Garcia had fallen victim to a reality slip, leaving her just a few timelines removed from her original. Next, the story of an anonymous blogger who goes by the name of James Richards, and who also claims to have experienced a parallel world where the Beatles never broke up. His story, again posted online, and which he claims happened on September 9th, 2009, is certainly attention-grabbing. First, he says that he cannot reveal his true name due to safety concerns, and then he reveals all about how he came to own an apparent genuine Beatles album that was never actually released in this reality. According to his account, Richards, with his dog, had been driving through Del Puerto Canyon, California, when he pulled over for a rest and to let his dog out for a walk. When the dog started chasing down a rabbit, though, Richards ran in pursuit, literally fell or tripped down a rabbit hole, and wound up unconscious. When he came to, he was in a strange room in a strange house. His head had been bandaged, and judging by outside noise, he was no longer in a rural location like the one he just left. Soon, another man entered his room. The man introduced himself as Jonas, and Richards thanked him for his help before asking a load of questions. Where was he? How did he get here? And was his dog okay? Thankfully, the dog was there too, and totally fine. But the other questions had far less straightforward answers. Richard says that Jonas then revealed to him that he was actually just a few feet away from where he had fallen. The house and apparent town outside hadn't been there before, however, because Jonas had also taken Richards to a parallel world, to an alternate dimension that he, Jonas, called home. Jonas then went on to explain that in his world, parallel travel machines were all the rage. Yes, they could be dangerous, but they were also a wholly accepted technology. Richard suggests that parallel travel may have even superseded space travel in this other place. The pair then spend the next few hours together, including for a meal that Richard says was basically normal except for purple ketchup. The really interesting hook, though, came when they started talking about music. Richards discovered that in Jonas's world, the Beatles were still touring. The iconic Liverpool group were still together, with all four members still very much alive. Jonas had a collection of albums too, mostly on tape, as Richards says that CDs had never really caught on in the other dimension. There was a version of Sgt. Pepper's Lonely Hearts Club Band on the other side, although Richards recalls that the famous cover looked slightly different in some ways. Better still, there were later albums, post-Beatles breakup in our timeline, that Richards had never seen or heard before. He and Jonas apparently whiled away some of their time together, listening to all of that later material. Finally, and just before Jonas transported Richards back to his own reality, Richard says that he managed to steal one of the later tapes, which, according to his blog post, has the title Everyday Chemistry. Upon returning to this plane of reality then, Richards uploaded Everyday Chemistry for all to hear, an apparently never before seen Beatles album, because it really doesn't exist for us. It was soon pointed out that the new tracks sounded very much like variously mashed up versions of some of the Beatles' solo material. But one counter-argument says that that isn't so unexpected. After all, in just a slightly altered version of reality, John, Paul, George, and Ringo might well have had many of the same ideas again, mightn't they? What do you think about the bizarre Beatles story and the unnerving tale of Lerina Garcia? Both have their own unique space in the modern history of the strange and unknown, but could they really serve as proof of parallel universes? What do you think? Is there anything we missed? Let us know in the comments. Check out these other clips from Unveiled, and make sure you subscribe and ring the bell for our latest content.